This video is a continuation of our discussion about the Konica Minolta print controller for the AccurioPresses. Specifically, this driver that we're looking at is for the IC-605 on the Konica Minolta AccurioPress C3080. This information also applies to the black and white Accurio line as well. To start with, we're going to look at three buttons on this video: the paper, the cover, and the page settings. Beginning on the paper button where we are now, I can see I've got a section for the paper tray settings and a section for paper profiles. There is currently no information populated in the paper trays, but there are paper profiles listed. These paper profiles were remembered from the last time we opened this driver up and acquired the data from the machine. The paper tray information is blank at this time. If I would like it to populate that data, I can click the Acquire Tray and Paper Data button. And you can see that that returns back, puts a green check indicating that it was successful. And we can also see now that it has paper populated into each of the trays. So when we are at this position, we can operate this selection in a couple of different manners. I can choose the paper by selecting the tray directly. If I want to pull specifically from a tray, I can do that. I can select a paper from the paper profile by just picking one from the list of papers here. So I could say I want to use the 11x17 20-pound bond, and you'll see that it's now going to pull that paper. And since my paper tray is on auto, it's just going to look in the machine and figure out on its own that tray number 4 has that paper in the tray, so it will pull from there. If I were to specify from here that I wanted to pull from tray 3, you'll see that it now comes back and specifies that tray 3 has the 11x17 80-pound gloss text installed. So what this is telling me is that I'm specifically looking at tray number 3. It knows that tray number 3 has this paper in it, so it populates that as the profile that I'm going to select. So I can drive it by selecting the tray, or I can drive it by selecting the paper type. Even though I've selected tray number 3 and it has populated the type of paper that is here, I could come back in and specify that I want that to be a different paper. I could say I want the 20-pound bond to come from tray number 3. In this case, the machine would stop when the job got there and ask you to put the appropriate paper in that tray. If I return this back to auto, it's just going to find the paper in the tray. The other advantage to selecting the paper profile and leaving the paper tray on auto is that if you have the same paper in multiple trays, it will do tray switching between the trays and allow you to pull from one tray until it is exhausted and then begin pulling from the next tray in line. Another way that I can select the paper is by clicking directly onto one of the lines in the paper profile list. You'll see that I can scroll through the whole list to find the papers that I want. Once I've selected a paper here, I can click the Use Selected Profile button and it will populate it in here. I've also got an option if I scroll down a little bit here and find a custom size paper. You'll see that the button activates that allows me to register the selected size as a custom size. There's rarely a need to specifically register that. This paper is being picked up as a custom size back from the paper catalog that's defined in the driver. There's generally not an advantage to setting that as a selected custom size here, unless for some reason you need to go back into your application and have that try to populate back into the application. As we move along then to the cover button, this allows us to set up a couple of functions. One of them is a banner tray. In this case, the banner does not refer to a banner sheet, as in a long sheet that it's going to print a document longer than 19 inches on. This is actually more of a header sheet that it will use as a separator between jobs. So this is just saying, I'd like to pull a sheet to separate between jobs, and which tray would I like that to come from. I've then got a front cover tray and a back cover tray. These operate the same. I can say that I would like to pull a front cover from one of these trays. So if I say I want to pull the front cover from tray number 3, it will come back and it will populate and tell me what paper is in tray number 3. That is once again dependent on the fact that I have acquired the paper tray data from the previous tab so that it knows what paper is in that tray. I've got an option here to tell it how many sheets I would like to pull, so I could pull multiple sheets from that tray if I would like to. You'll notice here on the diagram on the right that this shows a blank sheet of paper and then page 1, 2, 3 following afterwards. At this point, I am pulling a blank sheet or a pre-printed sheet from that tray, and I'm not going to print anything on it in this job unless I select the print checkbox. If I put a check in the checkbox, you can see that now it says page 1 and page 2 are going to go on this cover sheet that I've defined. I've also got an option here that I can check to say that I want this to be a glossy print. It's going to change some of the settings internal to the machine to try to give a more glossy appearance to that sheet as it pulls through. If I move to the paper settings button, we'll see that we've got a couple options here that we can set as well. First, we've got chapters. Chapters are chapter start pages, so you would specify here the sheets that you want to appear on the front of a sheet when you're doing a duplex job. So I could say that I want page 4, page 9, page 23 to be on the front of a sheet of paper. And in this case, it would do the calculation to figure out that in order to get page number 4 to be on the front of a sheet of paper, it needs to do a blank insert on the back of page number 3, at which time the page number 4 would move to the front and my odds would be on the back, so it would have to insert another blank page after page 8 to get page 9 to be back on the front of the sheet. This does a couple of things for you. Number 1, it alleviates you from having to figure out how to get those pages to be on the front. The machine will determine whether it needs to insert blank pages. And the other advantage is that when the machine or the print driver inserts those blank pages into the job using this method, it does not charge you a click charge to insert those sheets in, compared to if you had padded the job up with blank pages to get the pagination to work out the way you want it for chapters. Since there's a page in the job, you will be charged a click charge for those sheets. Below that, I've got a section you can see here that it says double click here to add page specific settings. So if I double click there, I've got several options I can put in. I can say that I would like to insert a blank sheet before the first page or after certain pages. So if I choose before the first page, you can see that it just puts a line in here that says before the first page, it's going to insert a blank sheet. I've got the option here to say where I would like it to pull that paper from. If I double click this again, you'll see that I have my selection list again. I can say that I would like to insert blank sheets after pages, in which case I could come in and say which page numbers do I want to insert blank pages after. I might say I want to insert a blank page after number 6. One of the other things that I've got with that is I can specify the number of sheets that I would like to pull in. So I could say I would like to pull 2 blank sheets in after page 6. And once again, I can use my paper tray, paper profile, paper settings to specify which paper it is that I would like to have pulled in for that blank sheet. If I double click again, I've got print one-sided and print two-sided. What this lets me do is specify that for a range of pages, I want specifically to print those one-sided or specifically to print them two-sided. If, for example, I had my job set so that it was duplexing all the pages, but there were a few pages that I needed to print one-sided, I could say I'd like to print those one-sided. I can come in and I can tell it page number 7 and 9 through 12 should be printed one-sided, and those will now be printed one-sided even though the job itself is printed two-sided. You've got the same operation you could use for two-sided printing if your job was set for one-sided printing. If I return back to these selections and highlight them, I got a clear button at the bottom. I can also clear all to clear all of the settings out. I'll just clear a couple of the settings here. The last thing that I will look at is this repeat pages sections. Right now it's set to off. I could turn this to on and I could set a page frequency. I can set this to be 12, in which case it would come to page number 6, it would insert 2 sheets, it would go 12 more sheets and insert another page. So it basically gives it a repeating cycle. Every 12 pages within this document, reapply these settings that I've got in my specifications here.